Yusek, kahit 52 lang yan, marami-rami na yan eh. And people are asking how high the responsibility will go. Saan nakikita nyo? Indication. Kasi tinatanong, aabot ba yan kay the former PNP chief, for example? Aabot ba yan sa...
How high up?
It's not commander-in-chief dahil police eh. But aabot ba siya sa presidente? Let's be straight up.
Alam niyo ho, ano, again, no, these are 52 cases. That's really not for us to say. You know? Pero sa amin, siguro, just to put it in context, 52 cases involving more than 150 police officers. This is as far as the 52 is concerned. We're not even talking about the 300 plus. No? So, you know, this is probably, we're talking about 400 killed. Just with this 52 and the 300 plus cases and another 6,000, I guess we'll just leave it at that. You know, it's really up, you know, up to, well, people concerned or people interested to make the proper conclusions or to make the necessary inferences. Now, if at the end of the day, there's an investigation or there's a bigger investigation really into this whole thing, you know, after we've done our part in investigating as much as we can, And to really look very earnestly into what happened and what this was all about, well, you know, we'll gladly help when the time comes. I guess we'll cross the bridge when we get there.
If people,
okay,
if
I people... ask you this as a lawyer, no, how do you make this whole thing less cumbersome? And well, how do you increase the chances that that it will bear fruit? Because as it is, it just looks so futile to be going after thousands, possibly, of similar cases. What would you do? Would you, I mean, as a lawyer, would you lump them all together into a, I don't know, a class suit? Is there a legal remedy just to be able to obtain justice? Or is this like the martial law victims of abuse and torture where it will take years and years before they actually get justice? I mean, because we're talking here about possibly thousands, right? So how do you make it less of an exercise in futility to be going after case and finding a pattern but not really being able to present it that way in a court of law? How do you get justice exactly?
Alam mo, Luchi, then it then becomes, I guess, more a political issue, you know? Kasi it will depend na, no, on maybe the next administration to maybe look into this and maybe look into what happened, you know, during this, you know, anti-illegal drug campaign, to really examine it and to really see what went wrong, if there were issues, really. But nakaganon, because otherwise, no, we'll just have to, well, I guess I'll borrow your term, ano? We'll just have to go through the cumbersome process, eh, no? Kasi these are actually dead people who have relatives, no? Who are the interested parties, and as a and you know, in the normal course of things, they'll have to file their criminal complaints. Isa-isa po yan, ano? Ganyan, and then ganun talaga. Now, whether or not, you know, after this, somebody looks into this, like, for instance, maybe by way of analogy, like, for instance, yung martial law issue, no? Yung mga victims, ano? So, I guess, nagkaroon ng, ano, no? There was a law for compensation or whatever, or just really looked into the whole thing, no? As a big issue, no? And looked at it from a bigger perspective, ano? And to just really address it, not so much for compensation, but also to ensure that maybe campaigns like this will be undertaken more carefully the next time around. So, you know, these are issues that I guess for now, as far as we're concerned, is beyond, no, what the mandate that has been given to us as far as the review of these cases are concerned.
Yusek, I know individuals and organizations that are not intimidated by how cumbersome it can be, or even how gargantuan the task may be, just to dig through all of that, all of those documents and reports and so on. If those individuals and groups are so inclined, will they have access? Can they have access to the same documents that you're reviewing, even the thousands of documents? All they're saying, I know a lot of people saying this, and they can't get past even the FOI orders of this government and the FOI systems. Simple lang. Do what you have to do, but give us access. And can we have the same access to all of this data?
Robbie, apart from the 300 plus, apart from the 52, there are actually close to 100 cases pending in our courts against police officers because of these deaths arising from anti-illegal operations. Those records are available and they're available in our courts. It's just really a matter of going after these records. And like you said, digging up these records. Also, with regard to these 52 cases, these have been endorsed to the NBI, like we said. NBI goes through the whole process. Nakita niyo naman, maganda naman ang trabaho ng NBI ngayon. Ano, talagang, they've really been working hard. Minsan nga, I think we overwork them. We give them, we refer too many issues to them. But, you know, once these cases are filed, you know, they become part of public record again, no? And we will find out who these people are. Those documents will all be available. These documents are there, actually. I mean, sometimes, you know, it's easy. It's just as easy as going to the courts and looking for these documents. They're there.